Incandescent light settles down into a soft yellow dull. My twin mattress doesn't look so inviting. Its comforter is faded, dirty although clean, worn out and waiting for the day of trading it in for a queen-sized double person cover. These eyes don't want to stare down another night of me alone, the way it's been in bed for me every time day grows dark. The air conditioning wishes. Fan blades form unobserved dancing pantomime shadow. The glare from a cathode ray tube glows at steady grip. I sit, trying to convert my brainwaves to the monitor's dull gleam. Searching for my soul's solutions on a pirated internet TV show reel. All the animated X-Men, they know how I feel. Oh, Jean Grey. If you could only see that it's Wolverine who really loves you. Sure, he's got his inner demons, fits of rage, and past lovers, but you were possessed by the Phoenix, rescuer of worlds, and annihilator of a whole solar system. There's no way you've always got a grip on your telepathic powers. Can't you see? It's not the obvious Scott Summers, but the tortured, lonely Wolverine that you want. There's too much tension! And Battlestar Galactica, the new one, with all its hopeless plots and sordid drama, isn't going to make me rest easy. But I need something good before I get in this bed again. And I know that President Roslin or Starbuck or Commander Adama or one of the final five Cylons is going to lead the way to Earth and figure out how to get rid of Gaius Baltar and his grating, pansy philosophizing in a British accent. Ooh, President Roslin finally admits she loves Adama. It's about time, he says. Oh man, what a line! But I still feel that empty inside. And this computer screen lies, tells me I can sit still while the world orders itself aright. And Gregory House can't medically unravel my plot. Torture. Stargate Atlantis can't find peace in a Wraith and Replicator fight. There'd be no drama, no reason to watch, and I'm still watching! 3:30 in the freaking morning while the real conflict waits for me to enter. Slip in sheets. Wrestle with sleep while untasted dreams remind me who's not in my arms. I could fantasize it so.
Hey, baby.
And open my eyes to a taste so hollow and filled with regret. It hasn't taught my heart how to really love yet. It's never comfortable to step in, expose, throw off protective clothes and grow into invisible robes of hope. But your voice is stronger than the dull I see.
I will save you.
Gentler than these voices screaming, please, come soon! I want my room to be a place of rest and peace. Not distraction, not denial, not dancing away from feeling pain. My tongue yearns for joy when it rains. Eyes of innocence to replace past shame. Emotions not afraid to feel sad. And still smile that I'm safe and warm. Finding meaning, a friend, fulfillment in my single life circumstance.